I'm Alex Romero. I'm 22 years old and I'm a full-time trader. And I want to show you guys how I made $12,000 trading Forex in 2 weeks with the prop firm FTMO, which most of you guys have probably heard. I'm going to go through a breakdown in the chart of one of my trades and show you basically the progression of how I made the $12,000. Actually, on my way to withdrawing for the second time when this video is being recorded. And hopefully, you guys all came from my FTMO interview. And this is a different trade I'm actually breaking down. I broke down a different trade from FTMO. I broke down a long from the $12,000 account. Now I'm breaking down a short. Okay, so I think we are I think we're rolling. This is the receipt. I don't want to lie about nothing. I'm gonna show you guys how it is, and this is my profit for $12,366 with 42 cents. Can't forget the cents, they add up. The profit split was fully processed and payment was sent to me. So you guys know I got paid. So there's no ifs, ands, or buts. I am with FTMO. I've been with FTMO for about 2 months now, or a month actually. And this is my first profit, my profit split. You can now get paid bi-weekly or monthly. I chose bi-weekly because I really needed to get paid. And that was my first profit. If you see right here, it was a smooth coast with one real loss of a percent. I'm not going to show too much because this is my FTMO. I don't want nothing to happen. And I'm going to be going over one of my trades. It can be the trade where I won 3%, 1.5, the closing trade that won me the $12,000. And here it is. Here are all the trades I took. Here are the big wins and the small losses. My risk reward is 8.6, win rate 52%, which I don't like to really dwell on because truthfully, I only had one loss at a full 1% of what I risked. This is a little more than 1%. So my win rate really comes from. Well, my win rate decreased really from having these these moments where 36 seconds I was in a trade for because I entered and got out. I wasn't sure. I wanted a better entry. Did the same thing again, entered, wanted a better entry, got out, and then I finally stuck with it. So that's usually what happens, and that kind of hits your that kind of takes a hit for your win rate. So I would like to think my win rate is a lot higher. But this is my FTMO statistics. Here's the profit. And now I'm going to be going to the part where I break down the trade. So now that we're on the charts, I'm going to go over the trade that finally put the cap on the 12K. I hit this that I got paid out on Friday. I trade London session. So this was a short on the 10th right here. The final trade of the profit playout. So basically, when it comes down to it, right? When you come down to GJ and the trade that actually won me the account, a lot of things played a part in it, and it takes real candlestick reading and price action to really understand why we went with this trade. So basically, when it came down to it, we're at a huge key area based on the higher time frames. You go to the weekly time frame and you go pull back. And you go to the left, you see a bunch of rejection over here, but I kind of like to dial it down. I don't need, I don't need a huge box, right? I know where support and resistance is. I know where the supply and demand area is, where price is struggling to break. As you see over here on about X amount of weeks ago, we got a huge wick to the downside and closed bearish. Coming into this week, we already had started getting a huge wick. If you come down to the daily, a wick was already being formed. I'm going into this is almost like I'm going into London session, right? Pre-London, I'm analyzing. This is exactly how I would analyze the market. Price came up and hit this key area that we were that is marked off right here. And then we got a huge move down, right? Ignore this candle. Ignore this candle. This candle is almost like it didn't happen because it's going to give you how it ended up now that we're past that time, but we don't want to get there. This is what we're really looking at. This is where before price melted, we did a short, we won, as you saw. But this is really before any of that happened. So on the daily time frame, same thing. We're going bullish. So I would like to continue the bullish run, but if it's not there, it's not there. I would if it broke these highs, I would have looked to go on long, but it didn't. You went on a lower time frame, and then we're really going to see what really happened, right? So going into session, right? This is session 17. 17. This closed at 9 p.m. and then we waited till 1 in the morning. So as you see, and as we're going to read price right now. We had a key area. If it breaks above, we go long, but we're kind of looking at another scenario just in case that that doesn't happen. How would we go the other way, right? And price gave us some interesting wicks and candle closures, and I'm going to show you why, and I'm going to show you what I mean by that. You see price, right? You see price the night before. Price comes up. We come down. We reject this area. And then the next day, we come back up, and we get two things. One, we get this huge wick to the upside, very weak bullish candle. And then we get a bearish engulfing candle. Excuse me. Then we get a bearish engulfing candle, right? To me, the way I look at this is that this is a possible right here, this wick. I'm going to show you right here. This wick right here is a failure to make a new high. So longs are actually kind of starting to deteriorate. I'm trying to stay away from there because I feel like price failed to make a new high. And then we got a bearish engulfing candle come session. So now I feel like I want to treat this as a lower high, right? We're going to treat that as a lower high. We're in the L's. We want to short, right? Why is that not deleting? Anybody know what's going on? Delete. Wrong button. Oh, my keyboard's off. Oops. All right. So we have a lower high, failure to make a new high. We get a bearish engulfing candle. And now usually what I want to do is go to the lower time frames and see what I'm going to do. If it goes this way, what am I going to do? If it goes that way, what am I going to do? So far, I have a bearish bias, actually. If it goes bullish, we know what I want. And it's the only way I'll go bullish. The only way I'll go bullish is if we break above all these highs and clear the supply and demand area. It's just too strong. But we don't, right? We don't. Coming into session, this is on the lower time frame. This is that 4-hour wick. We come down and we have this mini consolidation area post. This is Asia session, right? This is Asia session. So we see price actually after this range during the Asia session melt. And now it is 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock. 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, boom, that's 1 o'clock. Now, let me show you how we caught that, right? I start taking trades at 1 o'clock pre-London. So I'm going to give you guys, you know, when I usually start trading. 1 o'clock pre-London, I like to push more towards session, which is 3 a.m. But I'm going to break it down to what happened, right? So Asia session, we already declared that we have failure to make new highs. We got a wick to the upside. You go down a lower time frame, we create this range. And during Asia and pre-London, we come down, break under, and we retest this little mini area of support and resistance, right? I am now going to draw a little mini area of support and resistance right here that is formed based on the 1 hour. You see all these wicks. How does that look on the 4 hour? We actually have a bearish candle and bullish candle. We have a newfound support and resistance. You go down in 1 hour. Right. And now basically, if price is going to keep pushing up, then we're going to keep pushing up. I'm not really looking to trade anything if it goes bullish until we clear these highs right here. But I actually believed with more confirmation, like the EMAs, you see how we now crossed under the blue 50 EMA. We crossed under the blue 50 EMA and we're looking across. Now we're looking to actually touch this 20 SMA. Right. So now we're under moving averages. We're breaking under on lower time frames, breaking structure on lower time frames, and now I have my set area, what I want to do, right? I want to go along up here, and that's the crucial thing. You want to know what to do and when, right? And keep it in your mind. Don't change nothing based on your emotions, right? You start seeing something, stick to what you originally said because it's going to save you. Price comes up, we form this little mini range, and now basically all I'm waiting for is for it to just continue this pattern, right? I want to continue this pattern. I want to target the next area of support and resistance, which would be this area right here. And just wait, right? We're going to go down to the 15 minute and we're basically going to go let session. We're going to let pre-London and we're going to let London hit, right? So now that you kind of look at on the lower time frame, kind of going to move it here, move it right there, right? Now let's see what happens. I'm actually going to go down to the 5 minute. We're going on in the 5 minute, and now we just wait. Boom. Price gives us the craziest rejection of this area of support and resistance, right? It breaks under, comes up, retest, and drops. Now we have this wick. Now we have this wick. Now, this was a very ugly entry because of that wick. Now, some things kind of change. You could have entered here, right? You could have entered off the impulse. Price would have closed back up. It would have scared you a little bit, but this is where I waited. This is where I waited, because now that we have this wick, I'm not entering until we break that wick. I'm not entering until we break that wick, because now this 5-minute candle came up closed, and now it's a scarier trade because we're not under support with this minor area support resistance. We actually wicked it. So now I know that there's something here. There is something here. Once we start to break under, we're going to take impulse entries. We're going to go short. Now I have my definitive entry. Now I have my definitive stops, which is going to be above this area, little minor area I got drawn here. See what happens next. Boom, we're in. As soon as we start breaking that candle, we're in. Now let's see how the trade peeled out. Price kept going. Price came up, waked up. Price almost takes us out. Price starts to reverse. Price is chilling. Price rejects. Break and retest again. If you see, break, retest, boom. And now this is where we're clear. I believe. Boom. Price just melted. It's just, we were kind of scared for a little bit. We almost got taken out for a hole. I mean, honestly, our stops were probably a little more safe, right? Right? Actually, a lot more safe because we didn't. This was the winning trade. I wanted to close out on a Thursday. So we could have actually held out, but we didn't. And price just ended up absolutely melting. And if you see what happened after, let's look on the 30 minute. Prices continued to melt. This was a huge move. This is a move that really went nine times your risk, maybe even more. Consolidated. I feel like there was another drop. Yeah, there it goes. Price continued to drop another 322 pips from our entry, which is insane. This trade, if it was held for a duration of 3 days, it would have been the crazy swing trade. I am a swing trader. I do like to get in and out sometimes if I can. Usually it depends on how much I make. Yeah, if I made 3 times my risk, I'm not going to swing it. Probably close, come back the next night. But this was a trade that ended up going for 322 pips. We closed out with only about 54. But I wanted to play safe. This is my next area support resistance, and this trade absolutely nutted, just dropped. If we held it, we probably would have made a lot, but I probably wouldn't have swung it anyways because remember the day and time. It was Friday, and then to hold it for 3 days, you're not holding over the weekend. On FTMO, you can't hold over the weekend, so I probably wouldn't have held it. And that was how we capped off our amazing $12,000 in 2 weeks. In terms of how I marked up my support and resistances, my charts, the technicals I use, I do use the fib, I do use the moving averages. That'll be in a later video, but that's basically how I made my profits on FTMO for the very first time. And that's really how I trade. Real precise candlestick reading is key. Price action and market structure is the only thing you need. Everything else is just, spices and salt and to make your meal taste better. You want a nice healthy meal. No one wants it raw, no one wants it bland. You want it nice, sauced up, salt, pepper, oregano. I can't think of anything else. And that's what makes it better, right? You got a meal and you want to make it better, so you add more things. If not, you just don't eat it. You eat something else, and that's really how it comes to trading. That's how I'm going to break it down, is by eating. Don't just take anything just because you have to. You don't always have to trade every night. These are my tips. You don't always have to trade every night. Be patient. That's probably the biggest thing I've learned during these FTMO challenges and FTMO counts. Be patient. And yeah, man, just believe, just believe, just believe, just believe, just believe in yourself. I'll definitely be back making more videos. I'll see you guys later. Thank you for watching.